Hi, I'm Sherrie Clark, and welcome to Be Courage to Be Seen, the podcast that gives you the tools and techniques and insights to have more courage in your life, to be more authentic, confident, and empowered to achieve the success that you desire. Last month, we talked about setting up 2020 to be your best year yet. We did some reflection on 2019 and what you accomplished, you know, what an ideal year would look like, and then set up action plans so you could actually have 2020, your best year yet. However, it doesn't matter if you're listening to this at the beginning of the year, if it's 3 months in or 6 months in. You know, a lot of people don't even like New Year's resolutions. And I don't really know if New Year's resolutions are that important or not. I think, though, using the new year or any reason to take some time to do reflection, set goals and action plans is worthwhile. So if you haven't listened to the last episode, I encourage you to do that. However, as I was talking to people, you know, after we did that, I realized there's really a topic that I didn't include, and I wish I would have. And so I think it's so important that I wanted to make this episode focus fully on that. And that really is, how do we think bigger? How do we set bigger goals, bigger dreams? And so this episode, instead of focusing on action plans, you can accomplish more. I would like us to take some time on how you can think bigger, and then you can have the confidence to set big dreams, big goals, and really accomplish your desires. One of my favorite quotes is, if your dreams do not scare you, they are not big enough. And I really want you to think about, you know, what are your dreams? Do you have any that scare you? I look at this quote a lot because I think we all should have at least some dreams, even if we don't want to admit them to other people, then actually, if you actually accomplish them, they would scare you. So as I was talking to several women, you know, a common topic that comes up when we think about goals is what I call, you know, picking from the menu. Not really setting goals, not really taking time to think about what you want, but more about, okay, these are the types of things that I'd want to accomplish, and I'm going to just like choose from them because they're like acceptable goals. And we often filter our goals to make sure that they're appropriate, they're likely to be reached, maybe they're expected, or they're approved by others. You know, I think I used to only really have goals that I thought would be likely to reach. You know, you could kind of compare and contrast this with my husband. You know, as long as I knew him, he always had a goal of like owning an airplane. He wanted to have a jet. He'd even buy magazines, you know, of airplanes. He'd look at them on the internet. He'd look for how much they'd be sold. The chances were never, ever buying an airplane, right? They cost millions of dollars or at least hundreds of thousands. I have no idea, but airplanes are expensive. So I used to think that was crazy, that he had this goal, that he wanted to have an airplane. And like, why would you be wasting time to buy magazines and look at the classified ads for airplanes? Because we're never going to buy an airplane. But that's how he thought. I, unfortunately, would filter my goals on, if I thought that they were likely or something I could accomplish, I would list it as a goal. But if I didn't know how you could actually accomplish it, it's like, oh, I just filter it out. And we don't want to do that. Now, things that I may think are likely to accomplish, you know, could be different from you. So the filters would be different. Like one of my goals, which I accomplished last year, was to hike the Great Wall of China. And so I have it on my list because I go to China. That seemed like a very maybe achievable goal for me. But if you've never left the United States, you might not ever think to list that as a goal because you don't even know how to get a passport, you know, and so it's not achievable. But we don't want to filter our goals. You know, you don't want to only have things that you know are likely to be reached today, because if you never even admit that that's your goal, you may not find a way to accomplish something in the future. So do you have trouble knowing and thinking about, you know, what you want to accomplish or even say what your goals are? You know, let me give you a couple examples of what this kind of looks like. So when I start a mentoring session with someone, you know, I ask them, you know, what are your goals? What do you want to accomplish? Often people have to say, I'm going to have to come back to you. Like they don't know. They have to, they haven't actually written them down. Do you have your list? Do you know what your goals are, what your dreams, your desires? Another one that comes up a lot that I find is sometimes when I ask people that want to work with me that, you know, well, so, all right, so what's your goal? What's your career goal? And they tell me, well, I want to be you, or I want to have your job, or I want to have a job like yours. And I always find that interesting because many times this is from somebody that doesn't know me that well. And when they say, well, I want to be you, or I want to have a career like yours, I think you don't really know what, you know, my life is like. Yeah, I got a great husband and two kids and a great engineering team. But, you know, there's as much stuff in my life that's probably not very good as there is good stuff. And so this is all taken from the menu. It's like you see things, right? Your goal is I want my boss's job. That's an easy goal. And it's socially acceptable to say that that's what you want. But that's not maybe what you really want at all. You know, a better goal might be that you want to lead large engineering teams, or you want to lead an international business, or you can set goals without having it to be so specific. So that way it is more likely of what you want. So when people ask me or say, well, I want your job, I'm like, well, what part of my job do you like? What do you want? Do you want to have a strategic job? Do you want to be very technical? Do you want to lead large teams, et cetera? So you can kind of, you don't have to be, well, this is the three things that are open to me. I'm going to pick one. I'm going to set that as my goal. So let's do an exercise. I want you to take a few minutes and make a list of your top, you know, goals, dreams, desires for 2020. Now, if you listened to the last episode and you already have a list for 2020, you can use that. If not, I really want you to take some time and make a list. Now, if you're driving, you might have to make a mental list, but I would take the time later and actually write down, you know, what are some of your goals, your dreams and desires for 2020. It's important that you do have this, because then we're going to review this and I'm going to ask you questions. And this way you can look at how big are your goals and your dreams and your desires. Do they need to be bigger? And are you doing some filtering, maybe unintentionally? So take that list. If you need to pause this, you can. If not, come back and listen to it again after you've had a chance to make that list. The first thing I want you to think about is how long is your list? Now, I don't know if there's a right length of list, so I can't tell you it's too long or too short. But if it's not very big, it's not very long, the chance is you've already filtered it without even thinking about it. And so I want you to take some time to make a longer list. So a great exercise to do is set a timer for 10 or 20 minutes and pick a topic. Maybe start with things like career and write down, you know, things on the list. Add to it for 10 or 20 minutes all your goals, desires, dreams around your career. What would that look like? And then take another 10 or 20 minutes and do it on finances. And then do it again on like relationships. When you do this for a set amount of time, you may have like 5 minutes left. You say, well, I've already written everything, but keep going. Let yourself like really just get imaginative. What else it could be. Let your mind go. Turn those filters off. You have to keep going and going to really get out of the habit of having the filters on. So even though you're not going to actually put action plans to everything on your list, practice making long lists when it comes to goals, dreams, and desires. If you find out you have a habit of making too short of lists. Now, on the other hand, if you have too long of a list, like maybe it looks like you have just a lot of things, but you're trying to just include everything. So that way, like nothing gets left off. Like you're afraid if you don't have everything covered, you might not get what you want. So if this is the case, I would encourage you to take a new piece of paper and make two lists. And on the top, list one, first priority. And then on the second list, call it second priority. Then take your first list that you had and split it into these two lists. Take every item and put it on either first or second priority. The only key is Your first priority list can't be any longer than your second priority list. This will basically make you divide the list from a priority standpoint in half. It can be tough. The first things are easy, but eventually you're like, oh, I want to keep everything on my first priority list. And the reality is you need to identify, you know, what things are you just putting in there so you have the fear of missing out versus what things do you really want? The next thing I want you to take your list and look at it. Can you group it into categories? Like maybe let's talk about travel and you have a dozen different places that you want to visit, but they all could be travel. So if that's the case, then, you know, maybe your list isn't as long as you thought it is, because really doing some travel in the year would be good enough. You don't really have to hit every single place like that's on your list this year. So look and see if there are some categories that you can do. And then how many categories do you have? I'd say a minimum. You should always make sure that you have goals that cover your career, your health, finances, something around family, friends, relationships, and then also personal development. Now, you don't have to have everything categorized into these categories, but you should make sure that you have some topics on your list, at least into these items. The next thing I'd ask you is, what did you call your list? Was it a goal list? Was it a dream list? Was it a 2020 desire list? If you call your list something different, you might actually put different things on it. If you think about goals, many times we use, like we've been kind of conditioned to call them SMART goals, right? Specific, measurable, actionable. So they're things that you actually, you know, going to put an action plan together to go do. So maybe it is, I'm going to put 2% more in my 401k this year. Or I'm going to save $10 a week at Starbucks and bring my coffee or something. But very specific things that you can say, did I accomplish them or not? Now, if you say it's a 2020 dream list, how does that change kind of what your list is? Is it like farther out, you know, more lofty goals? Maybe not even things that you thought about that you would put an action plan around. Right? Maybe it's that you're going to want to live on a beach home, you know, on the ocean. Maybe it, instead of saying, I want to save 2% more, you know, in my 401k this year, you'd have a dream of, I'd like to have $1 million in the bank. I don't know what it might be for you, but you might find just by calling your list something different, that different things go on the list. Now, what if you would call that your list, your 2020 desire list? You know, what emotion does that bring up? Now that it's a desire list, you might find that you don't even want to share it with anyone. It's like almost too personal. It's not something that, you know, is actually to go out there. You know, that can make people self-conscious. Like, I can tell you my goals, but I don't know if I want to tell you my desires. Like a lot of people have that reaction. And so I'd be curious of what you named yours. And maybe you should try to give it a different name and redo the exercise. So if you have a goal list, try making a 2020 dream list. And then maybe redo the exercise one more time and make a 2020 desire list. And really then look and compare and contrast your lists and see how are they different? Are some small in terms of like, I want to save a couple dollars a week, you know, buying coffee, or I want to change my 401k contribution? Those are all still very important things in our lives, right? But are they really, you know, thinking bigger and what you really want to accomplish? So try making a dream list or make a desire list in addition to a goal list, and see, it's just words. It really shouldn't matter, but actually, you know, emotionally, it can trigger different things in you, and you may find it to be very, very different. The next step I'd like you to do as you look at your list, next to each item, I'd like you to rate it high, medium, or low on the likelihood that it will be accomplished in 2020. So just go through and say, yes, I think this is highly likely I can get it done. Or maybe 50-50 chance getting done. And then the last one, less than 25% chance we'll probably actually get it as written accomplished in 2020. And then go back through and count up how many highs are on your list, how many mediums, and how many lows. Now, I know I'm always talking about taking action. And we want to make plans that are actionable. So then you'd say, oh, we should have our list full of things that are likely to get done. And look, I put an action plan together and everything is high on my list. That might be what your list looks like. And that we're kind of conditioned for that. In reality, though, we want to have some things that are high and likely to be accomplished, but we actually want some medium and lows on our list too. Because some of the lows, maybe you can still get them accomplished, but maybe it's low because you don't know how you're going to get it accomplished. You're going to need some help from somebody. And if everything is high, the chances you did some filtering and you're not thinking big enough. So depending on how your list looks, you know, take 5, 10, 20 minutes. Do some brainstorming and add to your list so you have a better balance between high, medium, or low. And this is another one of those things that it's not science of exactly it needs to be, you know, 30%, 30%, 30%. You maybe want to have 50% likely to be accomplished and 10% are lows, not that likely to be accomplished next year. But figure out what works for you, but make sure you have some of each. You want to have some big lofty goals that challenge yourself. It doesn't mean you're not going to work on them, but they really do push the limit. And then you want to have things that, you know, help keep you moving forward and keep that momentum. The next step, I want you to look at each thing on your list and ask yourself, why did you put it on your list? Is it really your dream? Is it your goal? Or is it really someone else's? If it's someone else's, I would say take it off your list. You don't need to have it there. You don't want to focus on it anymore. You know, a lot of times, maybe somebody studied something in college that their parents wanted to them. So now they have this career that they don't really want, but it's kind of what was expected of them. Is a great example or something to think about. But think about the things on your list. Which ones are really yours and keep them? The things that aren't yours, if it doesn't motivate you, if it doesn't get you, you know, wanting to go and start taking action, then you may just want to cross it off, which is okay because it's your list. The next question that I would ask you is, how would you feel if someone saw your list? So think about that. We don't have to post them on social media. Everyone doesn't have to know all your goals, even though I do encourage you to share your goals because you're more likely to actually achieve things when you share them. However, if you are completely okay with people 100% seeing your list, then you probably already filtered it and you only put the things on it that others may think is socially acceptable. So do you need to add things to your list? It's a private list, so you can go ahead and think big. You know, I was doing a list last year. And I put on my list that I wanted to change the world. Now, I know that's a very you know, lofty, crazy kind of thing to say. But, you know, it actually triggered emotions in me. I'm not exactly sure how I want to change the world. But I know I actually want to change the world in some way, in some shape, in some form. But, you know, at first, I didn't want to tell anybody that. It was like it was something that had to be a secret because of that. It's like, whoa, as soon as you tell people I'm going to change the world, people question, are you worthy to do that? Do you think you're worthy yourself to even have that goal? And so you should have some things on your list that are bigger than you, bigger things that you can grow into, and that maybe you don't want to share them quite yet. And that's completely okay. The last question that I would ask you is, how long has each item been on your list? If you really could recycle every year the same old list, then you could say, well, is this really the list that you want? Is it really a list that's motivating you? And so if not, you maybe need to cross some things off. You know, maybe they're not really your goals. Maybe that's not really what you want. And that you should take some time to brainstorm and add to your list if your list is kind of old. Now, on the other hand, maybe they're big items that you're going to take many, many years to work on. And as long as it's still something that you can feel emotionally attached to, keep it on your list. But don't think you have to keep it on your list just because you've always had it there. Feel free to cross it off and create a new list if you need be. There's a quote that says, no matter how small you start, always dream and think big. If you start with small thoughts, then you will stay with small thoughts, by Stephen Richard. I think this really kind of fits in what we're talking to. We want to think big. We want to expand what we think is possible. Then we can work on developing action plans to get started. And maybe, you know, the initial achievements will be small, but at least if they're in the direction of your big, lofty goals and dreams and desires, then you will find out that you will achieve just so much more. So I want you to start out with a clean sheet of paper. On the top, you know, write 2020 and then pick. Is this your 2020 goals, dreams, or desires list? Maybe you want to put them all on there, goals, dreams, and desires. So that way you don't filter and you let all those emotions come up of what the list should be. Create a new list. Keep in mind the things that we talked about and that you aren't filtering. And so that way you're thinking bigger. Now you can do this in a couple of different ways. And it does take practice because this is a muscle that you may or may not have a lot of experience using. So you could set up and do like 10 minutes a day for the next couple of weeks and just keep adding to your list and think about, you know, what should be on there. Other people may find it's really good if you could have like a couple hour block and just really focus and don't be interrupted and create a good list. I like to do these kind of mental activities while I'm traveling. You know, I find, you know, airplanes is a time when I actually can think and I don't get really interrupted, especially, you know, long international flights. And so find out what works for you, but take some time and do some journaling. You know, write down, you know, what are these goals, dreams, and desires? Make them unfiltered. You don't have to keep them all in the end, but practice dreaming and thinking bigger and bigger. And so that way, as then we make our action plans, you can start from a point where you're really motivated on your list. So then take a look at your new list and compare it to your old list. Which one is longer? You know, is your list now, you know, longer than it was before? Maybe you had a really long list before, but it wasn't very specific. And now at least things are more what you want them to be. Which one makes you more excited? You know, which one are you more attached to? Which one are you more motivated that you want to get started? So after you take your list, then, you know, look at it and pick out the things. Okay, what should we focus on for 2020? We talked about this in the last episode. Once you have identified the things that you want to focus on, make if it's so big, it might take multiple years. You know, what can you actually do this year? Write it out, make an action plan of things that you could start right away. Don't just make the list and then set it aside. Find things that you could take action on, you know, right now. That my husband and I were driving and we were talking about, you know, one day we'd like to live internationally. And so we were thinking, well, from an action plan, we're not going to do this right now, but we could start to look at, hey, what's it even cost if we wanted to do like a long-term rental someplace? And that's a great action to get started. So we actually know and have an idea what we want it to be. So I hope you enjoyed this episode and you're starting to think bigger and think about, you know, what should your dreams and desires really be for 2020. I encourage you to subscribe, you know, wherever you like to listen to your podcast. So that way you don't miss the next episodes. You could check out my website, CourageToBeSeen.com, to learn more about me and my coaching program. My email is Sherrie@CourageToBeSeen.com. I love to hear from you and get feedback on what you like, what you'd like to hear more of, you know, ideas for the next episodes. Check me out on Instagram and Facebook. And so thanks for listening, and I look forward to talking to you soon.